The E. coli in the samples should be cultured to measure the amount of fecal contamination in your living environment. The samples are cultured by following the steps described here: preparation, hand washing, disinfection, dilution, sample incubation, and hand washing. You need to prepare sanitizers, gloves, a place to wash your hands, soap, a marker, a notebook, a pen, collected samples, dilution containers with 9 milliliters of dilution water, and plates for fecal contamination measurements. Wash your hands, wear gloves, and disinfect the gloves too. Disinfect the workstation as well. If too many bacteria will overlap, they cannot be counted correctly, so dilute the sample first. For dilution, use the collected sample, the dilution container with 9 milliliters of dilution water, and a marker. Before diluting the sample, write down the names of the sample, the dilution factors, and the names of the teams on the bottles with the undiluted, 10-fold diluted, and 100-fold diluted samples. The bottle with the original sample is the undiluted sample. First, shake the bottle well. Then, pour exactly 1 milliliter of the undiluted water sample into the 10-fold dilution bottle. This is your 10-fold diluted sample. Next, shake the bottle with the 10-fold diluted sample well and pour exactly 1 milliliter of this sample into the 100-fold dilution bottle. This is your 100-fold diluted sample. Just before performing each dilution process, make sure that you shake the sample bottle very well so that the concentration of the sample is uniform. E. coli is cultured from the undiluted, 10-fold diluted, and 100-fold diluted samples. The plate is soaked with agar to feed the E. coli and allow it to grow on the plate. Tiny E. coli bacteria that you cannot see with your naked eye will grow to form a mass of E. coli, which will then become visible to you. Prepare 3 plates, each with the undiluted, 10-fold diluted, and 100-fold diluted samples. This means that you will need to prepare 9 plates in total. Label each plate with the sample name, dilution factor, and team name. You will be labeling 9 plates in all. First, shake the sample water well. Remove the lid of the plate, turn the bottle upside down, and using the marks on the bottle, drop exactly 1 milliliter of the sample on the plate. Confirm that the dropped sample has spread on the plate, and then close the lid. Repeat this process 2 more times in each dilution. You will have a total of 3 plates for each dilution. The plate with the sample water should be warmed for 24 hours at 35 degrees Celsius in an incubator to let the E. coli grow. When you are finished with the process, disinfect the workstation and wash your hands thoroughly to protect yourself from contamination. Make sure that the opening and inside of the container do not come in contact with your hands, spout, or any other media. Label all the samples carefully so that they are diluted correctly and no mistakes are made. Also, be sure to measure the sample amount accurately.